Hey everyone, this is your friend. Welcome to our channel. We are going to deal with the topic drug toxicity, and this is the part 2 of drug toxicity. Part 1 has already been uploaded, so please visit the link in the description box to know more about that. And if you have not watched part 1 and you have directly come to the part 2, you are not going to understand much of it. So please, it is a request, please visit part 1 as well. So let us start with this drug toxicity. The number one is intolerance. Now, intolerance is inability to tolerate drugs. Here example is being given of statin therapy. Statin is a drug which is generally taken to lower cholesterol levels in blood. But this statin, whenever statin therapy is going on, the patients are found with muscle pain or weakness as a side effect. So this is about intolerance. Second is blood dyscrasias, that means blood disorder, and it mostly occurs due to toxic effects of drug on bone marrow. So therefore blood dyscrasias, and example of the drug, one example has been provided to you, that is chloramphenicol. And this chloramphenicol leads to leukopenia, agranulocytosis, aplastic anemia and hemolytic anemia. Now, what does leukopenia mean? So, leukopenia is decrease in number of WBCs, that is white blood cells. Now, agranulocytosis, it is decrease in WBC, but WBC has various types. From that, decrease in WBC is commonly known as neutrophils. So there is decrease in neutrophils, so it is known as agranulocytosis. Then it is aplastic anemia. In this aplastic anemia, the body fails to produce blood cells. And in hemolytic anemia, RBCs are destroyed very fast, then they are produced. So the destruction rate of RBCs is increased and its production rate is decreased. Destruction increased, production decreased. So this is hemolytic anemia. So these are the two types. Let us move to the next. Hepatotoxicity. Now, it is a state of toxic damage to liver. Hepato, the word hepato is related to liver. So, therefore, a state of toxic damage to the liver. Now, here, the most of the halogenated hydrocarbons are toxic. And example of that is, hydrocarbons is tetrachloride, then trichloroethylene, then tetrachloroethylene and trichloroethane. All these types of halogenated hydrocarbons are harmful, or we can say toxic, to the liver. Therefore, hepatotoxicity. Then nephrotoxicity, it is a state of, nephro is related to nephron, that is kidney. So example here is sulfonamides that produce damage in the form of crystalluria, albuminuria and hematuria. Now, crystalluria, as the name crystal, so there will be fogginess in the urine with release of crystals. Albuminuria is release of albumin, protein albumin, in the urine. And hemato is related to heme, that is blood. So blood in urine. So this is very harmful effect, we can say, of sulfonamides. Now here one picture has been given. This is inside a healthy kidney and this is damaged kidney. So as you can see, here albumin has been shown as this brown color, a small circle you can say. So here blood filter and urine is without albumin here in this healthy kidney. But over here, damaged kidney, urine is being filled with albumin. How we can say that? Because this circular portion, this all is nothing but albumin molecules, we can say. So That was the graphical diagrammatical representation. Now let us move to the next. Behavioral toxicity is sometimes or at certain times drugs may alter the normal behavior. That means the normal effect of the drug is being changed. So example here is atropine produces euphoria, excitation and mania at toxic dose. Whenever this atropine level is increased, so that drug is going to show euphoria. Euphoria is extreme happiness, excitation, and mania is, we can say, very much happy, great happiness, excited. So this, and this is also not like good. So atropine produces extreme happiness, excitement and all at toxic dose. So this is the behavioral, we can say, toxicity. Now let us move to the drug induced disease. Now here, as the name, drug is inducing a disease. So at certain times drugs themselves produce diseases. Example, here it is known as drug induced disease is also known as iatrogenic disease. And example is Parkinsonism by chlorpromazine. Here the normal neuron has been shown and the dopamine and the normal movement has been shown. But whenever there is Parkinson's affected neuron, so the dopamine level has been decreased and the movement, there will be disorder in the movement because it won't be working properly. Because as here you can see, all the receptors are getting dopamine, that is a grayish circular form we can see over here. Now here also receptors are there, but only some of the molecules of dopamine are present, and these receptors over here is empty. So therefore we can see it very clearly that it is abnormal. And dopamine is a neurotransmitter and it is responsible for signal transfer. So as you can see here, the dopamine level is less, so there won't be any signal transfer or transmission proper. So therefore the movement disorders. So this is about drug induced disease. Let us move to the next. Unmasking of disease. Now unmasking hidden disease. So this, the example is isoniazid can unmask hidden epilepsy. Epilepsy in Hindi, it is known as mirgi. So epilepsy, and it is a neurological disorder by sudden sensory disturbance. Epilepsy is nothing but a sudden, we can say, disturbance in the central nervous system, and then the person feels like unconsciousness and various symptoms are been there. So that is unmasking hidden disease is also a type of drug toxicity, and the drug is isoniazid. This can unmask epilepsy. So this is about unmasking. Then let us move to the next one. It is endocrine disturbances. On prolonged administration, that means if we are taking a drug for a long time, example reserpine, might produce endocrine disturbances, and it can lead to feminization in males and reduction in fertility in females. So here the males can show or like behave like females, like that. So feminization, and females can lose their fertility. So this is about endocrine disturbance. The next is electrolyte disturbances. Example we can say is corticosteroids may produce sodium retention and edema. It means whenever corticosteroids are being taken, it may produce sodium retention. That means sodium will be not, the sodium potassium, that pump won't be working properly in the body, and sodium will be retention is means it will be accumulated in the skin. So there will be edema. Edema is swelling of the skin. So that is electrolytic disturbance. Then skin reactions is the drugs which are applied on the skin, that is drugs of local application, it can produce skin rashes. So this is about toxicity, drug toxicity of skin reactions. Now let us move to the next. Next is carcinogenesis. Now here no drug has been found to be directly carcinogenic in humans, but WHO classified estrogen as carcinogenic. WHO is World Health Organization and it has classified estrogen as carcinogen. So that is the thing. Now let us move to the teratogenic effects. Teratogens are drugs, chemicals or even infections that can cause abnormal fetal development. Now here teratogens, the best example is thalidomide. This drug thalidomide, it produces phocomelia. Now what does phocomelia means? The babies which are born with short limbs, that short limbs are like directly attached to the body trunk and they have very short limbs, so like dwarf babies. So that is all because of thalidomide. If the pregnant lady is on the thalidomide, we can say doses, so that lady can deliver abnormal child with this short limbs. So that is about teratogenic effects. Teratogens are those drugs or chemicals that cause abnormal fetal development. So teratogenic. Next is addiction. Here it is as written as drug dependence. So here the person is totally mentally and physically dependent on the drug. And it has various adverse effects, we all know. Here patient can go under overpowering desire to take the drug or tendency to increase the dose. All this can happen, and also that drug addiction could be detrimental to the society and the individual. It will have great adverse effects on society and the individual. So that is about addiction. This is also kind of drug toxicity. People become addict. So this is all about drug toxicity. Hey guys, if you liked our video, please do like, share and subscribe. And please press the notification bell icon so that you can get the latest updates.